Mesela atomun çekirdeğinde proton ve nötron var. Nötronlar adı üstünde zaten nötr olan yük taşıyorlar. Protonlar da pozitif elektrik taşıyorlar. Dış yörüngelerde elektronlar dönüyor.
There are protons and neutrons in the nuclei of atoms. As we can see from the name, neutrons have a neutral charge, while protons have a positive charge. Electrons revolve in their external orbits, but at an unbelievable speed and regularity, never hitting one another. Of course, there is a glorious mathematical system. I mean, for instance, 100 electrons may revolve around the nucleus, but never bang into one another. The nucleus and electrons should normally amalgamate together. The protons and electrons should stick together. People claim that the centrifugal force arising as they revolve at high speed stops them doing that. Okay, let's accept that centrifugal force stops them all colliding together. But in my opinion, it's created as a miracle. This is not a reasonable explanation. Not reasonable at all. For one thing, there is no explanation for the energy involved in their revolving around one another for millions of years. This is a huge miracle. They have been revolving around one another as long as the Earth has been around. The process started and the revolution has been continuing magnificently and at the very highest speed ever since. They orbit at a speed of 50,000 revolutions a second. That means a huge force, and they never stray from their paths. Let's consider the iron atom. Someone hits it with a hammer. Under normal conditions, the electrons in it should fly apart under the effect of centrifugal force, but in no way does it get affected by it. Allah has brought it into being with a huge power. There's a complete void between them. Indeed, that's what scientists say. They say that the eye perceives matter as a solid whole, but that's not actually the case at all. Scientists say that the matter is transparent because there's so much empty space between the protons and the nucleus, between the nucleus and the electron. It is, the nucleus is here, and the electron is as far away as the Bahçeli Evler district of Istanbul. That's the kind of amazing distance. That's why matter in fact has a transparent structure. Scientists say we can effectively disregard what's on the outside. It's 99.9% empty. But scientists say the eye perceives it as solid. They say there is no light on the outside, only light waves. But that's how the eye perceives it, they say, how the brain perceives it. They say there is no sound on the outside, only sound waves. But that is again how the brain perceives it. That's how it perceives matter. And they say there is no time on the outside. That's just how the brain perceives time, they say. There is also no time outside. That establishes a really marvelous and metaphysical state of affairs. It's really, really astonishing. This regularity in the atom, this extraordinary effort it makes, which has no petrol or anything to run on. Atoms receive no energy from anywhere. They have been set in motion and never stray from their paths. How can this happen? 80 or 90 electrons all revolve around a tiny nucleus, 50,000 times a second, at a speed of thousands of kilometers an hour. But they never normally hit one another. All people regard this as if this is something very ordinary. Just a single atom is a very great miracle. For instance, we are currently touching this object, but touching is not possible. There is actually no touching going on at all. There is repulsion in the structure of atoms. When we touch something, for instance, the electrons in our fingertips and those out there repel one another. But we never make direct contact with what we are touching. This feeling of touch stems from one of repulsion. That is, it stems from repulsion. We perceive that feeling of touch because of repulsion. This is not something that is very well known. In other words, no two pieces of matter can touch one another as they repel one another. We touched here, a sensation of touch formed, but that stemmed from repulsion. It stems from a powerful sense of repulsion. We imagine we touch things, but we really don't. Allah has created such wondrous things to bring this about. If people could see at the very smallest, most minute level, just the structure of the atom would easily be sufficient to lead people to faith. And this shows the system of the atom. Look, there are protons and neutrons at its center. The electrons revolve around it. They go around it 50,000 times a second. They revolve at the speed of 150,000 kilometers per hour. People talk about that as if it were something very simple, but they have been moving at the same amazing speed since the world was created. They have no petrol or diesel or electricity or anything else. They continue within that force that Allah has given them and will do so until Day of Judgment. Protons and neutrons hold on to one another. Meanwhile, there are tiny subparticles that join them to one another. There may be up to 100 electrons, more than 100. But they all keep moving at that incredible speed of 50,000 kilometers a second, going around 50,000 times at a speed of 150,000 kilometers and never crash into one another. Yes, the atom. Now it has a nucleus in the center. Let's imagine there's a small melon here and an electron in the Silivri district of Istanbul whizzing around it 50,000 times a second, and it never strays from its path, not even if you hit it with a hammer. Think of the size of the atom and the power of its energy. It goes around the nucleus 50,000 times a second, and not even a hammer blow is enough to put it off course. That alone is a very, very great miracle. Because it's a very delicate matter. Why should the electron revolve? Why should it go around 50,000 times? Why should it be so tightly bound to the nucleus? And where does its energy come from? The electron has been revolving for millions of years, and it keeps on turning. Do you think it is a repetition of the name of Allah? Of course, Almighty Allah tells us that we cannot hear it. But every living thing repeats the name of Allah.